Search category1games.com, and we are taking a look at Inquest number 12 from April of 1996. This is exciting because this is a Middle Earth the Wizards special look at it. So first off, we've got some ads for the NFL Red Zone, Ancient Hearts, Vampire, Rage, or the Amazon. We've got the contents page here. Wyvern with information about the different sets. Look at those Wyvern gold coins. I Want More CCGs by the editor-in-chief, Pat McCollum. How cool would it be to have battle Cyberdyne and its Terminator squad in a new CCG? It actually happened. Good thing, right? Inquisitions, Gamers Gripe. Look at this cool ad for Middle Earth. I mean, you see this and you're like, man, I want this game. This is the game I want, right? Eat Me with Cheese, Name of the Game. Magic creations, where people created their own cards. Now, if you go back and look at my older Inquest, we're skipping quite a bit ahead, and this is it's cool to see how Inquest grew and changed over time. So, like, here's the NBA Fast Break. I believe this was a Wildstorm. The Wildstorm comic book company created this. They later were sold to the company itself. Wildstorm was sold to DC Comics and is now imprint of that. That's Jim Lee's company, if you've heard of that name. Toy Wizards, Toy Wizard Head Wizards Magic, new vice president oversee all the aspects of magic licensing and new product development. I don't know how long Richard Fukutaki was in that position, or if he still is. I have no idea. Let's see. Alliances follow Magic's Ice Age. So here's an article talking about how Alliances is going to follow up on Ice Age and that theme. A new Ice Age expansion called Alliances will be out by June. Now, if you remember, in this time period of Magic, they were thinking that Alliances was almost like a separate game. No, sorry, not Alliances. Ice Age was like a separate game. So Alliances wasn't a Magic expansion. It was an Ice Age expansion, which is weird to think because they didn't have it quite figured out like we do today as far as how Magic releases go. They're still figuring this sort of thing out. So it was really interesting. Here's a Donruss work in progress, like with NFL Red Zone. XXX marks a spot. I still have never once seen one of those cards in person. Microprose strikes again. I mean, that is a terrible reptile from Mortal Kombat 2. If you're like, love Mortal Kombat 2, and you say that, you're like, come on. The Star Wars two-player game. Really cool to see an ad for that. They did such a good job with this ad. It's just really stands out. On the shelves. Okay, so here's upcoming game releases. So this is April 1996. I mean, this is when gaming was at its height. I mean, this was just everything was flooding the market. Tons of games out. So, like, here's Shadowlands. And this was for L5R. Here's a Wildstorm Player's Guide. Vampire, Mythos. You know, White Wolf, War of the Amazon. So that's a Rage. You know, just Dragon's Dice was a thing at the time. I mean, this is just so many games coming out. One of the things I really liked about Wizard this time was best in tournament level magic decks, and they'd give you different magic decks to try out. If you look at them now, you're kind of like, was this really a good deck? But I remember there's a later issue that I'll get to where I actually took this page out and built that deck and would go to tournaments with it and did okay. Unfortunately, when I get to that review, that page isn't there to even talk about the deck because I took it out. Non-killer deck, Electric Boogaloo. Let's see, Up Your Sleeve, Surprise Strategies for Unappreciated Magic Cards. So here's Serrated Arrows, and I remember this card got a little bit of play because it's one of the few decent cards, I guess, in Homelands, but still, it just wasn't that great of a card. Magic Stumpers, I never really cared for this myself. This just wasn't my thing. More Dragon stuff, here's some original artwork you can buy. Limited print, so not even original, it's just reprinted artwork from some of the cards. Here's Magic the Expansion, the Gallery fan-made expansion cards for Magic the Gathering. I always thought these were really cool. I took and I would cut these out of the Star Wars ones and glue them onto cards, make actual cards out of it, and try to play them in decks just for fun, you know, with friends. And people at the start want to do that in a tournament or anything. But I always liked these. These were really cool to see what people came up with as far as cards go. Like Days of Chaos, you know, original artwork on some of these. Some of it's like really good. Like this Forgotten Lords. I mean, look how cool that artwork is. I think it's pretty sweet. Whereas you have other artwork that, you know, is not as detailed, but, you know, fits the card. Like, here's this, let's see here, Kappa Oriented Dominia. Anyways, really cool layout. Now, here's some of you big Middle Earth fans. Here's Lord of the Rings, the 10 most desirable Middle Earth the Wizards cards. So at this time, these were the top 10 cards to get. One Ring, Favor of Valor, Mouth of Sauron, Will of Sauron, Shadowfax, Shelob, Elrond, Dwarven Ring, Durin's Tribe, Isles of the Dead That Live, Siege, and then honorable mention is Gandalf. And Gandalf came in starter, so that wouldn't really be that hard to get. I think it came in starters. Am I wrong here? I don't know. Tell me in the comments if I am. Here's a contest, a vampire contest. Let's see, grand prize. One lucky reader will receive two Vampire the Eternal Struggle cards autographed by the respective artists and a whole honkin' display box of Vampire the Eternal Struggle Ancient Hearts booster packs. That's pretty cool. I like that. Here's a new game coming up, Heresy Kingdom Come. Has anybody out there played that game? Is it fun? Do you know anything about this game? If so, you know, let me know. Really interesting. Here's a James Bond 007 game. Obviously, this was the Pierce Brosnan era before GoldenEye was released, the game for Nintendo 64. Ed Beard Jr., an artist, so just a profile on him, what he's interested in. Top of the Order by Donruss, the baseball card game. And they're trying to get the baseball card market in, you know, those that collected baseball cards or sports cards into the card gaming market. You know, that way you could still collect your favorite athletes and stars, but still play a game with it instead of just having them sit in a notebook or in a sleeve or in a card box. Without Dragons, this is Enter the Dragon. Without Dragons, the entire fantasy genre would suck. Here's a historical perspective on the King of Fantasy Beasts. Now, if you're a big dragon fan, this might be really interesting to you, like how they came about. But when, like, I would read Inquest or these different types of magazines, there's an article like that. I didn't really care. Let's see here. Here's the old the Armory. I mean, they've been around a long time. I think they're still in business, if I'm not mistaken. Largest supplier of Wizards of the Coast products from coast to coast in Europe, too. So pretty cool. Game Master, let's see, game designer Steve Jackson spills the beans on his early gaming career and the state of the industry today and how the government always shut his companies down. Well, I don't know if it's because he didn't pay taxes or what, but you do got to do that. The Secret Service shut me down for a while in 1990 because they can't tell games from reality. They raided us because they thought one of my staff was a monster, criminal, hacker, conspirator. It nearly put us out of business. Everything they believed was so wrong, it was ludicrous. With the help of the Electronic Frontier Foundation, we sued them for damages. It took years, but we won. Interesting. I would be curious to see what the article has to say, but I don't really know if I care to really take the time to read it. Basic training. So this is the game On the Edge. This is basically how to play and different strategies related to that. I have never played that game. I have some of this game. And plan to eventually put it onto the website. But for now, I don't know much about it. Atlas Games presents a pretty darned Arcana contest. I also never played this game or really heard of it. If you know anything about it, let me know. Ultimate Chaos Top Part 2. The top CCGs battle to be King of the Hill. So I think they just had different card games and they'd play them against each other to see which ones were the best. Remember when card sleeves were first becoming big? Like, shuffle it, deal with it, store it, protect it. Magic actually banned sleeves for a while, which is crazy to think that people were having to play in tournaments without sleeves. And that's why finding good condition of those early sets is so hard, is because people just couldn't play with sleeves. And once the sleeves caught on, you know, not everybody was using them. The Three Sisters of Magic. Let's see here. Neutral Ground, Game Masters, Shahrazad Games. I love looking at these old ads, and I always am curious if the companies are still in business, as well as what games they're advertising. Like, here's Italian Legends, Italian Dark, The Dark. That's just interesting to see. Paul and Judy's Coins and Cards. Let's see. Cardstock, tracking trends in the game card game market. So Magic is dethroned. The top-selling game... Look at this. Top selling game during this time was Star Wars. Can you believe it? Magic has been bumped from number one slot. Retailers across the country are reporting that Vader, Solo, and the gang are outselling Magic. I mean, that's crazy to think now. You know, Star Wars CCG lasted until 2001. And, you know, it's crazy to think that, like, the original Vader, Solo, Skywalker were selling for as much as $50 to $75 each. However, prices seem to have settled across the country to $20 to $35. Vader falls on the high end of that range, with C-3PO and Kenobi at the low end. Expect to find Leia, Skywalker, and Solo somewhere in the middle. Crazy. What about Star Trek? Most retailers report that Star Trek Alternate Universe is a distant third behind Star Wars and Magic in recent sales. Crazy. Comic City's Thrush proposes a reason for that phenomenon. Decipher allowed too much time to pass between the release of the unlimited version of Star Trek and Alternate Universe. If I'm not mistaken, I believe it was a year. Much of the momentum they had going was lost and has not been recaptured. Mike Bickford of Comic and Cards in Twinsburg, Ohio, offers an additional thought. Star Wars is a fairly easy game to learn, and beyond that, it's fun. Star Trek plays slow, and that's what prevented many gamers from getting involved in Alternate Universe. Bickford points out that the most individuals buying Star Trek in his shop are collectors and not gamers. Interesting, and I believe that Star Trek stayed that way up until later on when, what was it, First Contact came out. All right, price guide, top 10 hottest cards. I'll show you as you go through. Termagoyf, Deflation, Clone, or Deflection, Icy Manipulator, Autumn Willow. Crazy to think Autumn Willow is the fourth most important. And the hottest card is Baron Sengir, which is just crazy. Jester's Cap and Dual Lands. I mean, this tells you the time period that we were in, where Homelands, you know, how much was Baron Sengir going for? Baron Sengir was $10, $7 to $10. Crazy to think. You know, here's the other games that they had prices on. Really interesting that they did this. And then here they would have Magic, like they'd show combos. And then these are like April Fool's combos. So they're telling you combos that I don't believe really worked. Anyways, really interesting. I love these old Inquests. Oh, look, a Player's Guide to Middle Earth. So here's all the cards, and they listed how playable they thought they were. And then combos with them. Really interesting. Anyway, so this was just a review of this Inquest. Look at that wizard. I bet that was a cool one. Toy and action figure issue. This is before they actually had a toy magazine specifically. And they would do it part of Wizard. And it was really funny. And it eventually led to their own magazine. Netrunner CCG. All right. This is Scott with Category 1 Games. I hope you enjoyed our look back at Inquest number 12. If you saw any games in there you liked or want to talk about it, please post below. Like the video. Follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Please support us. You know, you can buy from our web store. That really helps us out. Thanks, everyone.